are the only living being in this world who create problems. Other living beings survive by following the nature, their way of life. Human beings have no system and they do not follow the nature. And today here on this earth there are 6 billion human beings. Each and every person think individually. There are no 2 people who think equally. This is the nature of the human mind. When the United Nations wanted to draft the Constitution, preamble to the Constitution, they have written like this: war begins in the human mind, and peace also must come from the human mind. Actually, they are repeating what the Buddha has said in Dhammapada, first stanza, Mano Pubbangama Dhamma. Human mind is responsible for everything good and bad that exists in this world. So, war, violence, disturbances, bloodshed come from the human mind, not from the hell. If all these problems come from the human mind, then peace, calmness also must come from the human mind. Peace never come down from heaven. Peace never come down from God. Peace come from the human mind. So this is one of the important points that they have mentioned to overcome our human problems. I remember many years ago, 4 ambassadors from 4 countries came to see me. Sri Lanka, Burma, Pakistan, and Russia. They told me they always discuss these problems, but we have different opinions. Therefore, we decided, Sri Lankan High Commission suggested, why not we go to a Buddhist temple and discuss this matter with the Reverend. Then, first started by Pakistan ambassador. He said, we are talking how to overcome or settle our human problems. But I strongly believe unless or until we develop faith toward God, there won't be any solution or peace on this earth. Therefore, belief in God is the only solution for us to overcome all our problems. Then I told him, there are millions or billions of human beings who believe in God, very strongly believe. But do you think those who believe in God live peacefully without facing any violence or bloodshed or war or disturbances or without creating problems? Therefore, how can you say only those who believe in God can live without creating problems or knowing how to overcome their problems? Then, Burmese ambassador said, if we want to overcome our problems, we had to educate people. Without proper education, it is impossible for us to overcome our human problems. Then I told him, there are many in this world who are educated. Most of those problems come from the educated people. They create more problems than innocent people or uneducated people. Therefore, I don't think that education is the solution for us to overcome our problem. Why? The modern education is academic knowledge, book knowledge, or worldly knowledge. This word, education, is derived from a Greek word, ediko. Ediko means development. Development of the mind is called education. By knowing everything under the sun and the moon in this world, there won't be any development in our mind. Please remember this. Therefore, we have neglected the real meaning of this word by using the word education, that is academic knowledge or worldly knowledge, but no development, no discipline in their mind. Educated people can create more violence by using their intellect, by misusing, abusing their intellect. They can create more problems. But uneducated people are innocent. They do not know how to create so many problems. Then, Russian ambassador says, if we want to overcome our human problems, we had to abolish capitalism. We had to divide everything equally without any discrimination. No rich people, no poor people. Then we will be able to overcome our human problems. Then I told him, there are countries like Russia or China and some other countries where they try to adapt this way of life. Could they manage to overcome their problems? In fact, they are facing more problems than any other countries. On the other hand, it is against the nature. By force, we cannot abolish this. Take for instance, today we distribute everything equally, but after a few months we can see how many people have become rich, how many people have become poor. Because cunning people, clever people know how to bluff and swindle and steal, and they become rich. Innocent people become very poor. Therefore, we cannot go against the nature to overcome our human problems. Then, they say, they had to discuss further to find out certain solution, actually, how to face our problems. Then I said, one day, somebody came and asked this question, from the Buddha. He said, we have so many problems, tangles and entangle, internal and external. In simple language, so many problems we had to face, but we do not know how to overcome, but create more problems when we try to overcome our existing problems. Now that was the question. Then the Buddha gave the answer. He said, yes, there is a method. Sile patitthaya naro sapanyo cittang panyanca bhavaya. Atapi nipako bhikkhu so imang vijataye jata. This is the answer given by the Buddha. Venerable Buddha Gosa, the commentator who has written commentaries to the Pali Tripitaka, has written one book by taking these sayings of the Buddha. He has written nearly 700 pages by taking these sayings of the Buddha. Then what does it mean? Sile patitthaya naro sapanyo. If we want to overcome our human problems, first thing that we have to cultivate is discipline, sila, morals, principles. Without cultivating these qualities, these virtues, it is impossible for us to overcome any of our problems. Here you can understand, discipline is the most important things in our life. That is the real meaning of education. When you refer to Sanskrit language, there's a saying, Vidya dadati vinayang, vinayadeti patratam. Patratvam dhanamanyeti. Here, Vidya means education. In English, we say education. In Greek, we say another word, ediko. In Sanskrit, we say vidya. Vidya gives vinaya, discipline. Education means we learn how to live, how to talk, how to do our work by adapting certain discipline. Otherwise, we can make a lot of mistake, disturbances, violence, if there is no discipline. Therefore, we must know how to behave in different places, different attitude. When you come to a place of worship, you had to cultivate your discipline in different ways. When you work in the society, you had to adapt certain discipline in different ways. When you are at home, in front of your parents, in front of your children, in front of women, they had to behave by following certain discipline. Here you can understand everywhere, wherever we live, there must be some sort of discipline. And this discipline encourage for people to welcome us, entertain, support, having seen how we behave. Therefore, we cannot neglect certain principles, certain manners that people have been maintaining for thousands of years, like India, China. Their culture, their discipline, their manners are very important to maintain our discipline, our way of life. And to develop our relationship, our understanding, our cooperation. Therefore, without discipline, whatever we are going to do, that can become a failure. According to the Buddha, here, sila means moral development, religious principles. Without violating universal law, without violating the dharma. Dharma does not mean only the teachings of the Buddha. the whole world exists, move according to certain dharmata, that is called universal law, not created by God, not created by Buddha or anybody. The whole universe exists according to certain dharmata. So our duty is to harmonize, to cooperate, otherwise we get into trouble. If you want to go against the nature for our living, for our pleasure, we get into trouble. It is happening now all over the world. Human beings behave in such a way, they do certain thing, thinking that they are developing this world. Actually, they do not develop, they are destroying. Human beings are destroying this world, but other living beings never do that, because they follow the nature. Humans do not follow the nature, they are going against the nature. They are in trouble now. Therefore, you can understand how important it is for us to cultivate certain discipline. That is why here the Buddha says, the sila, discipline, moral development, principles, we must have. That is the foundation of our way of life, to overcome, to avoid, to settle our human problems. Then, second item he mentioned, cittang panyancha bhave. Chitta means mind. We must know what is in our mind. We know everything under the sun and the moon in this world, but we do not know the real nature of our own mind. We do not know what is happening in our mind. What we do not know, how to control our mind, how to make use of our mind. Therefore, mental development means understanding of the nature of the mind. The Buddha has mentioned in the teachings of the Buddha and Buddhist philosophy, it is mentioned that different people have different characters, different attitude and different mentality. All are not equal, but they must understand the nature of their own mind. Take for instance, some are very hot-tempered. Some are leading very romantic life. To them that is more important than anything else. And some others are so greedy. Their duty is collecting and accumulating. And some others have very narrow-mindedness. Their understanding is very, very poor. Some have very confused mind. They cannot come into a conclusion to understand things properly. Some are very intelligent, but they can misuse that intelligent if that intelligent is not guided properly. Now let us take, scientists have discovered so many things by using their intelligence. Without depending on God, without depending on religion, they could manage to discover wonderful things here in this world. But unfortunately, after that they misused what they have discovered for the destructive purpose. They discovered atom, energy. This energy, instead of using for constructive purpose, they produce nuclear weapons to destroy the whole world. People say, by using the existing nuclear weapons, they can destroy the whole world within half an hour. That is, human mind, intelligence, discovered, produced all these things. That is why Albert Einstein, one of the best scientists, everybody respect him. He says, science without religion is blind. Religion without science is lame or crippled. 100% correct what he says. Now scientists have discovered so many things, they misuse for the destructive purpose because they were in the dark. There is no religion to guide them, advise them how to make use of their discoveries without producing things to destroy for the whole world. On the other hand, religion without science is lame or crippled or not active. It is true. In the name of religion, people have written so many things in their holy books. Then say, this is given by the God, this is taught by the Buddha, and this is given by another prophet or messenger. They have recorded in their holy book. When scientists, intellectuals, great thinkers study these sayings in their holy books, they cannot agree, they cannot accept. Therefore, religion is in danger today. In the West, last month, Catholic magazine, I have read, in the West, more than 50% given up Christianity. Churches are empty. That is the trouble. Religion without science is in danger. 1998, Pope is the living God on this earth to Catholics. Pope announced, human beings were not created by the God. They come into existence due to gradual development of evolution. Because they had a losing battle with theory of evolution to show that God created human beings at once. But intellectuals all over the world accepted that it is not true. So no other choice. The Pope had to say, yes, human beings were not created by a God. I discussed this matter with the Archbishop of Kuala Lumpur. Why the Pope has said like this? He said actually, his idea is, this body is not created by the God. God creates only soul. That saying also contradicting to their holy book. Why? It is mentioned there, God created a man in the image of God. Then where is that image of God? That's why Albert Einstein says, religions that scientists cannot agree is inactive. But so far, scientists could not discover anything in this world that will contradict to the basic teachings of the Buddha. Not even one word uttered by the Buddha. Nobody in this world who can say the Buddha is wrong. The more they discovered new things, the more they come nearer to the Buddha. Now let us take Albert Einstein's theory of relativity. He has come so close to the Buddha. He says, one particular item cannot exist by itself, but by depending on something else. What the Buddha has said in Paticchasamuppada, dependent upon origination. Because of this, that one will appear. Because of that, this one will appear. Because of that, this one will appear. Then go one, be crowned. So, the more they discover, more they come nearer to the Buddha. So here you can understand now that human intelligence must be guided properly, otherwise they can destroy everything, and all the immoral, corrupted, wicked, cruel, dangerous things also come from that educated human mind. Therefore, education is not the solution, but we must try to understand the nature of our mind. By knowing that, we must have courage and knowledge and understanding by using our full effort how to control our weaknesses. All of us have weaknesses in our human mind. In fact, our anger, jealousy, grudge, ill will, enmity, all are weaknesses. We should not try to justify. All these are dangerous, all are weaknesses. By knowing this, we must use our full effort to subdue, to control, to suppress slowly. Then we can behave as cultured, harmless, respectable, noble human being without harming others, without disturbing others, without bluffing others. That is what the Buddha says. Must try to understand the nature of your own mind. Then you will be able to overcome many of those problems that you are facing, your internal or external. Problems are natural. There is no living beings in this world who have no problems, especially human beings, because of their mind. So, by knowing the nature of our mind, we must use our full effort, then we can understand. We are very noble. We are harmless. We are respectable. Then there is nobody to create problems and disturbances if you can understand the nature of our mind. Now, if we are hot-tempered, you must understand this is dangerous. This can create a lot of trouble, disturbances, enemies, calamities. Why not I try to control this? Then you are very jealous. Then you have to think, what do I gain by harboring jealousy? Nothing. I create very bad atmosphere. I create others as enemies for me. Therefore, why should I maintain this jealousy for nothing? Allow others also to experience pleasure, enjoyment, their way of life without creating jealousy, criticism, without passing remarks. That is another method for us to overcome our problem. We are very selfish. By disregarding others, we enjoy our life. When others are needed, our support, our assistance, our help, it is our duty as human being to give our helping hand, do what we can. Then we can reduce that selfishness. Here, one by one, when we study how many weaknesses are there in our mind, whether we are educated or not, whether we are religious minded or not, still we have many of these weaknesses. This is the second point the Buddha has pointed out. First, you had to cultivate your discipline, moral development, then try to understand the nature of your own mind. Another person cannot understand this, because another beautiful sayings of the Buddha: yassa papang katang kammang kusalena pithiyati. These sayings of the Buddha is very important for us, because there are people who approach you and tell you, although you have committed a lot of sins or bad karma, if you believe in God, He can wash away all your sins and send you to heaven. Especially at the dying moment, they approach. Many people accept this. They never think whether it is possible or impossible. Just accept. But the Buddha says, suddhi asuddhi pacchattang nanya manyang visodhi. Purity or impurity, good karma or bad karma, created by one person, another person cannot change this. Even the Buddha also cannot change this. God also cannot change this. But the person who has committed can do that. This is the sayings of the Buddha. Yassa papang katang kammang kusalena pithiyati. We have been committing certain bad deeds or bad karma. One day we realize, oh, these things are bad. Then determine not to commit, not to do it again. From that day onwards, we create more and more and more kusala karma. By cultivating more and more kusala karma, by using the same mind, but not by using another person's mind. Person who has committed the bad thing, now by using the same mind to cultivate good karma, kusala karma. There is another important point here. There are two words, punya karma and kusala karma. In English we say merit, because there is no another word. But these two words give two different meanings. Punya kamma, meritorious deeds, good deeds we have done with good intention, by aiming, by expecting any reward, worldly material gain. That is punya kamma. You want to enjoy your life, you want to go to heaven and enjoy your life, you want to be born in a rich family to enjoy your life, that is the purpose of your punya kamma. But kusala kamma is different. Kusala kamma means whatever good deeds that we do to reduce our craving, reduce our anger, to reduce our ignorance, that will become kusala kamma. This kusala kamma, when these karmic thoughts become very weighty, very heavy, bad karma that we have committed earlier had no chance to come and affect us, attack us. Let us take example. Angulimala, a murderer who has killed nearly 1,000 human beings. One day he met the Buddha. When the Buddha explained that his attitude is wrong, he understood, gave up, followed the Buddha, become a monk, attain arahantahood by using his full effort through meditation. After that, attain nirvana. All the bad karma that he had committed had no chance to affect him. Please remember, you are the only one who can forgive your sins. God or the Buddha cannot forgive your sin, so that the others cannot come and bluff you. God can take away all your sin and send you to heaven. Another simple example I can give as an advice. Assume you are very hot-tempered. You know it is wrong. You do not know how to control it. Then what do? You go to your God and kneel down and pray and ask the God, please take away my anger. I do not know how to get rid of this. Do you think there is any God in this world who can do that? Impossible. If not, you come to the Buddha and worship and ask the Buddha, please take away my anger from my mind. Do you think the Buddha can do that? Impossible. If the Buddha can do that, why the Buddha could not control Devadatta? Why he could not control Channa? Most stubborn, most created a lot of violence and disturbances, even tried to kill the Buddha also. Buddha could not take out the anger, hatred their mind. Here you can understand. There is nobody in this world who can do that, but you can do that. When you create strong determination in your mind, I want to withdraw this from my mind, then you get it. That is why Buddha say, not to depend on others. Final word, parting word of the Buddha. Attadipa bhikkhave viharata attasarana ananya sarana. Develop your self-confidence without depending on others for your salvation. These are the beautiful sayings of the Buddha. So people do not understand, never remember these kind of sayings of the Buddha. Because when Christians talk about Christianity, they say our Bible says like this, they can quote. When Muslims talk about Islam, they say our Quran says like this. When Buddhists talk about Buddhism, what do they say? People say like this. There is nobody to say the Buddha says like this. Now I have given so many quotations of the Buddha. They are very important for you to learn and to remember. Then others cannot bluff you, mislead you. Then you gain confidence. Oh, the Buddha has given this advice in this way for us to maintain. Go ahead with confidence. That is why here the Buddha says, you must try to understand the nature of your own mind. Then you can overcome many of your problems. Then come to the last word. Chittang panyancha bhave, panya. We started with discipline. Then we understood the nature of our own mind. We use our full effort to control, to develop, to discipline the mind, to purify the mind. Then in the end, what do we gain? Prajna, wisdom. Now we have no wisdom. We have only knowledge. Knowledge is not wisdom. Knowledge is the memory, what we have learned by hearing, by reading, whether science or technology or languages or history or geography, anything in this world. All these are memories. There is no wisdom. Wisdom never appears in our mind if we allow our human weaknesses to dominate our mind, when we reduce those evil forces from our mind, our knowledge slowly turn into wisdom through our experience. Here you can understand how the Buddha gained his enlightenment. People use this word but do not know actually what is enlightenment. If anybody asks, can you tell me, you follow the Buddha, you worship him, can you tell me who this Buddha is? How many people are there to give the correct answer to this question? So one day, when Buddha was going somewhere, he met a Brahmin. This person has never seen such serene figure, complexion, features. He thought this person must be a god. He came and asked, are you a god? The Buddha says, no. Others try to claim they are the god or son of god or messenger of god. But the Buddha says, no, I am not a god. Then he asks, any other form of supernatural living being? The Buddha says, no, I am very natural. Then he asks, then are you a human being? No. I am not ordinary manushya. Then who are you? Because confusing in his mind. The Buddha gave the correct answer. The self-introductions of the Buddha. If you can remember this, then you can understand, you can tell others who the Buddha is. Otherwise, you talk all sort of things according to your imagination. How he introduced himself? Abhinyayam abhinyatam. Understood are the things to be understood. That means he understood everything in this world. How did he do that? Not within one lifetime. By practicing 10 paramitas, life after life, he went on developing and developing and developing and developing up to the maximum level to understand everything. Then, bhave tabbancha bhavita. I have practiced all the great qualities, virtues, principles, precepts, morals, ethics, all the good qualities I have cultivated. Pahatabbang pahinang me. I have eradicated, uprooted all the evil thought, word, action. No evil, wicked, cruel, harmful, immoral attitude in his mind. Completely eradicated. Tasma buddhosmi brahmana. Therefore I am the Buddha. Not a god, not an angel, not an ordinary man. I am the Buddha. See what a wonderful introduction. If anybody asks who the Buddha is, are here. One who has completed these three things. What are those three? He understood everything that exists in this world. No one can say Buddha cannot understand this. He cultivated all the great qualities here in this world. He has eradicated all the evil thoughts, word and action. Then complete purity in the mind. Then supreme wisdom arose. After that he mentioned the nature of his wisdom. Chakkum udapadi, jnanam udapadi, panya udapadi, vidya udapadi, aloko udapadi, brightness. That is enlightenment. People measure, people use this word very loosely. to introduce enlightenment so easily. It has taken such a long period for Buddha to gain this enlightenment. By practicing these three, first observing all the principles, then developing, cultivating, realizing the nature of the mind, after that got the wisdom, supreme wisdom. Then no more human problems. Internal or external, all our problems are settled. Here, this is the answer to this question. I am advised to speak only up to 9 o'clock.